Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to start company accounts, chapter number 7, issue of debentures. If you remember, in the beginning we have discussed the company require a huge amount of finance, and for that purpose shares as well as debentures are issued by the company, and these are the most important sources of finance. And a lot of transaction related to issue of shares and debentures take place in every company. Just because of that, accounting treatment of those is also very important. In the previous chapter, chapter number 6, we just come to know that how the accounting treatment is to be done at the time of issue of shares. Now in chapter 7, you people just come to know that what are debentures and what is the accounting treatment of issuing the debenture. Let's see what are the learning objectives. By studying this chapter, you should be able to understand meaning and features of debenture, types of debenture, distinction between shares and debenture, issue of debenture for cash at par, at premium, and at discount. If you remember, in the previous chapter, we come to know what will be the accounting treatment of issue of shares for cash at par and premium, because as per the amendment, share cannot be issued at discount now. But debentures can be issued at discount. Issue at of debenture for consideration other than cash, it is also very similar to issue of shares consideration other than cash. The new topic is added, issue of debenture as collateral security, because debentures can be issued as collateral security while the shares cannot be issued as collateral security. I'll just make you the difference clear and I'll explain to you that what are collateral security and how the debentures are issued as collateral security. After that, you come to know accounting treatment of issue of debenture considering the terms and conditions of redemption, interest on debenture, writing of discount, loss on issue of debenture. A good news for all you people, you come to know and feel very happy that the next chapter related to redemption of debenture has been deducted. One chapter is your issue of shares, another chapter is your issue of debentures. So let's start this chapter, the issue of debenture today. This is the last chapter of your company accounts, consists of 15 marks total, complete company accounts. 10 marks carry this chapter, 15 marks, 5 marks carry by this chapter, and 10 marks carry by the previous chapter that we did, that is your issue of shares. So do it so well. Meaning of debenture. What is debenture? If you remember, in the 11th class business study, you come to know that a company can raise the funds by acquiring the share as well as by issue the debentures. The shares are the own fund of the company while the debentures are the borrowed fund of the company. A company, in addition to the capital of issue of share, if requiring the funds on long-term basis, may borrow the money from issue of debenture. A debenture issued by a company is usually in the form of a certificate given under the seal of the company, means company stamp is to be engraved on that. Thus, a debenture is written acknowledgement of a debt taken by a company, as these are issued under the seal of company. A debenture certificate contains the terms of repayment of the principal sum at the specified date and the term of the payment of interest at a fixed percent. If you remember and recall the flow chart that we did in our first lecture in the beginning of the company account, you people come to know a company issue the shares and the people who purchase the share are shareholder, and in return on the another side there is debentures are issued for borrowing the loan from the public, and it will be known as debenture holder and they will get interest with a fixed percent. Here, a definition of debenture is also given to you. Debenture includes the debenture stock, bonds, any other securities of the company. whether constituting a charge of assets or note. Now, characteristics or features of the debentures. What are the features? The debenture is issued by the company in the form of certificate, which is a written acknowledgement of debt taken by the company. It is very much clear by reading the first feature. The company issue a form of certificate, which is written acknowledgement of debt. Debt means the borrowing taken by the company. Second, a debenture is issued under the seal of the company. Third, it contains a contract for the repayment of principal sum at specified time. Fourth, as per the Company Act 2013, no company is allowed to issue a debenture having the maturity date more than 10 years from the date of issue. However, a company engaged in infrastructure project can issue the debenture for more than 10 years but not exceeding to 30 years. Please underline this point. From one mark point of view, it is very important that what can be the maximum maturity date. It can be the maturity date, not more than, it is the more than of, not more than of 10 years. But in case of infrastructure company, it should not be exceeding to 30 years. It means 10 to 30 years can be there or not exceeding to 30 years. In case in the type of MCQ or whether in the type of one mark question, true, false, you may get the question from this point. So please underline and mark a star against this point. It is very important. Number five, the fifth feature is usually the debentures are issued with a specified rate of interest, which is called coupon rate. Please underline this. One mark question is very important. What is coupon rate? Usually the debentures are issued with a specified rate of interest, which is called as coupon rate. A debenture holder receives interest on debenture at the specified rate as mentioned in the certificate. Payment of interest is made normally after every 6 months, whether the company makes a profit or not. Sixth point, a debenture is generally secured by the charge of assets of the company. This means that if the company is unable to repay the debenture as per the terms of issue, the debenture holder can move to the court and realize their money by getting the assets of the company sold. That's why the debentures are known as the secured debentures. These are the secured debentures because a debenture holder can claim its money by make a suit by court to the company. Seventh, funds raised by the issue of debenture are of long-term nature and usually the debentures are repaid after a long period, such as 7 years, 10 years or 12 years. As such, the loan raised by the issue of debenture is also called as loan capital. Please underline from one mark point of view, what is loan capital? The debentures issued to raise the loan is known as loan capital. So this is all about the features that we have done. Let's recall. First of all, we have done the meaning of debenture. Then we did one of the definition that is given under section 2, subsection 30, Company Act 2013. After that, we have done these seven characteristics or features of debenture. Now, a very interesting point from examination point of view, it is very important as well. But what is a bond? It is very much similar to that of debenture. Traditionally, bond has been issued by the government, but now these days are also being issued by various semi-government and non-government organizations. Main distinction between the debenture and bond. Please underline the main distinction between debenture and bond is with respect of rate of interest. Debentures are issued with fixed rate of interest, whereas bond can be issued without predetermined rate of interest, as in case of these deep discount bonds or zero coupon bond. Please underline what is the basic difference between bond and debenture. You may get this question, or you may get what is deep discount bond, what is zero discount bond, what is bond. Any of the question you find from one mark, then you find from this point. A deep discount bond or zero coupon bond is one which is issued without prefixed rate of interest and its issue price is heavily discounted. the difference between issue price and the redemption price. Please underline the difference between the issue price and redemption price represent the total interest to be spread over the duration of the bond. A proportion amount of total interest is to be charged to the statement of profit and loss every year over the lifetime of the bond. Now, after clarifying the meaning of bond, let's come to the types of debenture. That what are the types of debentures? Debentures are various of various types, and these are very interesting. A company may issue the following types of debenture. Number one, secured or mortgage debenture. These debentures are those which are secured either on a particular asset of a company called fixed charge or on all the assets of the company in general called a floating charge. Please underline the debenture are those which are secured either on a particular asset are called the fixed charge or on all the assets of the company in general is called the floating charge. Fixed charge denies a company from dealing with mortgage asset, whereas the floating charge does not prevent the company from using the asset. If a company is unable to repay its debenture on the due date, means repay means it is to be repaid to the debenture holder. The company will get its document back and give the money back to the debenture holder, means public. The debenture holder can realize the money from the asset mortgage charge, and second mortgage debenture are those having a second claim on the assets charge. In India, debentures have necessarily to be secured. So what are the secured or mortgage debentures? These are the debentures which has the floating and fixed charge on it, means that are the secured by completely assets, and in case of non-payment at the time of due date, the debenture holder can sue a company and claim its money by holding the assets, by realizing the assets, by selling the assets, anything else. So these type of debenture are absolutely secured. The second one is our unsecured or naked debenture. These debentures are those which are not given any security. The holder of such debenture are treated as unsecured creditor. At the time of liquidation of the company, such debenture are not very common these days. So much so that unless otherwise stated, a debenture is presumed to be secured. What are unsecured debenture? And another name of it is naked debenture. These debenture are those which are not given any security, and the holder of such debenture are treated as unsecured creditor at the time of liquidation of the company, means at the time of wind up of the company. Third one is the registered debenture. Name and addresses of the holder of such debenture are recorded in the register of the company called register of debenture holder. Such debentures are not freely transferable. The transfer of such debenture requires the execution of proper transfer deed. Principal amount and interest on such a debenture is paid or to the person whose name appears in the company's register. I'm telling you again, what is a registered debenture? When the name of the debentures holding the debentures, they are the holders of the debenture, their name and addresses are to be recorded in the register of company. This is called register of debenture holder. Such debenture are not freely transferable. Keep this point in your mind. Bearer debenture. Name and address of the holder of such debenture are not recorded in the company register. These debentures are transferable by mere delivery. Payment of principal and interest is made on the bearer of such debentures. Coupons are attached with those debentures and interest is paid to the such persons who produce the coupon in the specified bank. So, registered means whose name and addresses are holded in the register, and bearer debenture that are transferable and their name is not mentioned in the company's register. Redeemable and irredeemable debenture, fifth and sixth point. Very interesting. Redeemable. those debentures which are to be repaid by the company either in the lump sum at the end of present period or in installment during the life of the company. Any case may be, but if the debenture is repaid to the debenture holder, whether the lump sum amount is repaid or whether installment are repaid by the debenture holder to the company are known as the redeemable debenture. But if the debentures are not repayable or these are the perpetual one, perpetual means not redeemable, up to the time of the company's liquidation, as much as the company will go on, the debenture will go on. They will remain as the debenture holder of the company. The money will not be repaid to those debenture holders. So those are the irredeemable debentures, or in other words, we can say perpetual debentures. Next, convertible debenture. Convertible debentures are those debentures which are convertible into equity shares and other securities as stated rate of exchange, either at the option of debenture or option of company after a specified period. When only a part of amount of debenture is convertible into share, such debenture are called partly convertible. When the full amount is convertible into share, such debentures are called fully convertible debentures. I'm repeating once again, the debentures which are easily allowed to convert either in the equity share or any other security at the stated rate of exchange, either the option of the debenture holder or at the option of the company after a specified period, then it is known as the convertible debenture. It may be the partly convertible or it may be the fully convertible. SEBI guidelines require that where the conversion is to be made at or after 18 months from the date of allotment, but before the 36 months. Any conversion in the part or whole shall be optional on the part of debenture. Convertible debenture are very popular these days, and as it provides the liquidity, safety, capital appreciation, and assured return to the investor. Please underline one more question you may get. Why convertible debentures are so popular? What are the benefits of convertible debenture? Carry one mark, then you have to give the answer that is given in the last line only. So this is all about the types of the debenture. Let's recall: it's secured or mortgage debenture. Number two, unsecured or naked debenture. Number three, registered debenture. Number four, bearer debenture. Number five, redeemable debenture. Number six, irredeemable or perpetual debenture. Number seven, convertible debenture. So this is all about the meaning, definition, features, and types of debenture. I hope the concept, theoretical concept of the debenture is clear to you all. Earlier we studied, we learned shares. Let's differentiate the share and debentures now. See, shares. Share is a part of capital of the company, therefore the shareholder are the owners of the company. Debenture is a part of loan, and such debenture holder are the creditor of the company. Shareholder get the dividend from the company, that is a part of profit, while the debenture holder get interest from the company at a specified rate. Don't forget, fluctuating or fixed rate of dividend of interest. Dividend is paid only when there is profit. The rate of dividend may fluctuate from year to year depending upon the profit and decision of the director. But the rate of interest on debenture is absolutely fixed every time, and it must be paid irrespective of the company making a profit or incurring of the losses. Because interest on debenture is always considered as a charge, whether the firm is bearing, whether the company is bearing the losses, whether the company is enjoying the profit, the company has to pay interest with a specified rate to the debenture holder. Otherwise, debenture holder has complete right to sue the company. Fourth one, voluntary or compulsory redemption. It is at an option of the company to return the amount of share by buying back its own share, and the amount of debenture must be returned according to the terms of the issue. If I talk about the priority of the repayment of the amount, it is in case of winding up, the payment of the share capital made after the repayment of the debentures. In case of winding up, the payment of debenture is made before the payment of the share of share capital. Unsecured or secured, the shares are always unsecured, hence bear more risk. While the debentures can be secured from the assets of the company, or hence it may be bear a little risk. Restriction on the issue at discount. Under Section 53, Company Act 2013, shares cannot be issued at discount except sweat equity share, but there is no restriction on the issue of debentures at discount. Now, the last basis of difference is voting right. The share confers on the holder the right to participate and vote at the company's meeting. A holder of debenture neither possesses any voting right in the company's meeting, nor can participate in the meeting of the company. So this is all about the difference between the shares and debentures of the company. Read it thoroughly. It is very important to do the practical, to understand the basic concept of the share as well as debenture. After that, while doing the accounting treatment as per Section 39, Company Act 2013, there is also the minimum subscription condition applies on every type of securities, including debenture. Please underline and mark it. And whatever the debenture rate of interest, it is prefixed. Whenever you do the entry you did while issuing the share capital, those 8 entries are absolutely same. On the place of share capital, it is to be marked as debenture with a specific rate of percent. The rate of interest, and on the place of share application, you have to write debenture application. On the place of debenture share allotment, debenture allotment, the share call will be replaced by the debenture first call. Let's have a view about brief view about the entries. On the receipt of the application, money bank account debit to 12% debenture application. Earlier you did in case of share to share capital. Now it is replaced by 12% debenture application. On the transfer of the application money, 12% debenture application to 12% debenture. Earlier it was share application account debit to share capital, but now it is replaced by the debentures and its specified rate. On the refund of money in case of oversubscription, 12% debenture application to bank. In that we did share application to bank. Then share application to share allotment if any excess money is returned, adjusted to the allotment. Then 12% debenture allotment to 12% debenture account. Means share allotment to share capital. Now it is replaced by debenture allotment to debenture. Earlier, we did the entry at the time of receipt of allotment money, bank account debit to share allotment. Now we will do bank account debit to 12% debenture allotment account. On making the call money due, the entry you did in case of share capital, share first call account debit to share capital. Now you will do 12% debenture share first call account debit to 12% debenture account. On receipt of call money, you did the entry bank account debit to 12% debenture first call. But now you will do the entry 12% debenture first call. Earlier you was doing bank account debit to share first call. Everywhere you mark the share word, everywhere you mark the share capital, now it is replaced by the debenture. Just all the things in case of par premium, you have to do same. The entries related to due has to be done. The entries related to received has to be done. At premium is there. At par is there. Moreover, at discount is there, that I'll discuss in the upcoming example. By tomorrow, I'll start the numerical portion. Till that, you have to read each and every aspect of the theory as well as the example thoroughly, and revise the back exercise and clarify each and every concept about the debentures and what is the basic difference between debentures as well as share, because unless you clarify the concept, you can't do it practically. So concept should be clarified so well. Now I request sir to allow the student to have the queries if they have any. Sir, I request you to allow the student to have the queries.